I think what makes a good team is the bonding on the field and off the field, in the locker room, outside of football, like at school, feeling like a family.
You can play good, you can have great players, but it's really that teamwork, that bonding that you build. We weren't just friends, we became a family throughout this whole season, and memories I will never forget.
After the Pembroke game, we all knew we should have won that game. We were 0-2, coming off a 1-4 season in the spring.
From the very get-go, we were down a couple of players due to injury, and we weren't sure when they were going to be able to get back, if they were going to be able to get back to playing.
I tore my AC joint, which is in my shoulder on my throwing arm, so I had trouble lifting it and even throwing.
In the beginning of the season, after those two losses, the team, it was a little disorganized. You could see like some people not as passionate as others.
Me and my senior friends, we were talking, like some of us have never won like a varsity game.
We told each other we're not losing again. The more we brought in practice, the more we led our team. We got closer together, we got better together.
We knew at that point that we were a better team than what we were doing. So it was those two losses that really motivated us to want to win more and want to win for each other.
We just started building momentum, getting more confidence, and the coaches kept telling us that we were a good team, and we didn't really realize that until after we won a few games.
It's not about individualism. It's about that collective unit, and I think those things are born from a group of young athletes coming together and sacrificing themselves for the betterment of the team.
How can I give my teammate an opportunity to be successful so we can be successful as a team?
I know how good every single individual is on the team, and I want them to know that. I want to tell them, like, this is how good you are. Like, this is the big stage. It's time to bring it.
An injury, I was a little scared that it was gonna like affect the way I played. I didn't want to be the one to make the mistake, or I didn't want to like cost my team the game. They trusted me, and that really pushed me to do what I needed to do and do my best, and this is it really.
Senior year, it's, you know, every single game we say it's got to play like it's your last, but this is actually your last game.
We were just focusing on making it the best, like, last experience we could, because we knew it was the end.
You know, I would tell people, like, oh, I can't believe we're going to play Gillette. My heart was racing at night, too. I couldn't even go to sleep.
Having Coach Tangerlini on the sideline, who was part of that first team, he was very, very honest with the team in one of our post-practice talks. He's like, when they were going, they were so caught up in the awe of going to the Super Bowl. It was the first time that the program had ever been there. They kind of forgot about why they were there, and they got caught up in the moment. Next thing you know, they were down by 20 points in the first quarter.
Standing in the tunnel before the game, all the emotions and the awe kind of just set in.
You can't hear what's around you, but you hear your head, and you're like, man, this is awesome.
We saw just all the lights, all the, like, the Jumbotron.
Everyone in the stands cheering for us was, I try not to think about it too much, but it's definitely cool.
Coach Hayes is a very funny coach, but he's also very serious. During the locker room, when he read the poem, you know, it gave you enough adrenaline to run through the wall. He told us that he loved us, which is something that I don't think we've heard all year. And you could hear in his voice that he choked up a little bit. If this is the last ride that we got with these group of people, we're gonna go 100% right now.
I think we really came out with a lot of energy, and it started off with a trick play pass to Josh Burke.
Super Bowl, I think the main focus was to make sure that the assistants and I just resonated with this team, that it's not just about getting to Gillette, that we wanted to get there and get the job done. We had been there twice before, the first time we lost, and we didn't want that feeling. We were sitting there saying, we just need to continue to do what we're going to do. We're going to wear them down. We knew we were in a dogfight to some degree.
All of our teammates really had an impact on me. They really pushed me to become better, just showing, giving me looks and opportunity to take leadership of the game.
Got beat for a touchdown pass that was deep. It was okay, this team can hang with us.
Quacona, their O-line was really strong, and they had a running back that was really unstoppable in the regular season.
There was never a feeling of comfort. You always feel like something could happen that could just change that. So we knew that every single play we had to go our hardest and try our best to just extend the lead.
One big play, and it's a completely different game.
Over the course of a football game, the ups and the downs, play by play, series by series, quarter by quarter, you know, it's easy to let your emotions take over. And that's the hard part about coaching teenagers is, you know, teenagers are very emotional, and being able to get them to remain somewhat level-headed and not letting their emotions get the best of themselves when it came to playing the game and executing.
Playing at Gillette was it was really surreal. I think a lot of us had emotions where we were, and it may have affected the way we were thinking about the game.
We have this play called Bulldog, which is where I go in at quarterback, and I call a motion for Baker, and everyone's all focused on Baker. Looking up and seeing everyone go crazy, seeing myself on the Jumbotron, it felt awesome.
Felt that we were a better team and that we were a more physical team, and it just was going to take us a little bit longer than we anticipated, which we hoped it would be over in the first quarter, but it wasn't the case.
Throughout the game, we definitely let up some tough runs. To be honest, at halftime, I didn't even know we were up at the lead. I thought we were losing.
We're right there. We're making plays. We're pushing these guys around. We just got to clean it up. We got to clean up the execution, fundamental stuff, guys.
It was pretty cool to be in the locker room where the Patriots are and everything, and just being there, like watching the coaches talk. Our entire season has led up to that moment. No one was overconfident, but no one was also scared. We all knew if we kept playing our game, we were going to win it.
Coach A, he always says the most important play is the next. So no matter what mistake you make, it's all about the next play and how you do on the next play.
I think we came together. That was the most important thing.
We need to play as a team. We need to play for each other. We have to have our teammates' backs.
Trust everyone and know that they're going to do their job if you do yours. Friends playing football again.
Making the moment seem smaller than it was sort of helped the nerves go away. You're not here for the crowd. You're not here for the TV, you're here for a game.
Those are the Super Bowl games I went to as a kid with my family, and to be on that field playing with my family for Cohasset, for the school, my senior year, there's no feeling like it.
This great Harry Aganis Trophy for the Division 7 MIA State Football Champions in Cohasset High School.
You think about at night, you know, halfway during the season, like, oh, the Super Bowl, you know what I mean? What is that like? Just knowing that those memories with these people are never gone, and knowing that I did it with guys that I love the most.
It really goes by fast. You need to cherish every moment. The bus rides, the locker rooms, the games, the practices, the pasta dinners, everything. You really need to cherish it or else it's just gonna go like that.
I've never been on a closer sports team or a more successful sports team than this. And I said it multiple times throughout the year, like, this team, I've just never been closer to. It really felt like a family. And we were just all just friends playing football again.
We all had like such strong friendships and bonds that I think we all trusted each other a lot more, and we knew our goals and what we were set to accomplish.
You know, we look at previous Super Bowl teams, there was a star running back or a star quarterback or a star. You know, when you looked at our stat sheets, it was about even distribution between who caught the ball, who ran the ball, who had X amount of tackles. there wasn't any really one go-to player. I really, truly believe that what made this team so unique and so special was the team aspect of the unity, and they're all best friends.
We're fighting on it. We are the champions.
Cohasset, I love the coaches, the program. I just wish I could do this again with the boys. One more time.
I've been playing this with these boys since third grade. They're my family, and now we won the state chip. Let's go.
You know, it's been amazing. I really have no words for this for today, but I'm gonna miss Cohasset football. Here is out of sight. They don't bark and they don't bite. They keep things loose, they keep things alive. Every border with them.